Hi, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. Today, we will be talking about a topic that would certainly interest many patients with knee pain. Have you heard of osteoarthritis of the knee joint? In layman term, it simply means wear and tear and the loss of suspension of the knee joint. What are the causes of it? How do you know if you are suffering from it? What is the treatment for this condition? So watch till the end to learn about it. If you're new to my channel, please click on the subscribe and notification button now. Now let's take a look at the knee joint anatomy. In a young normal knee, there is a flexible slippery material that protects bone from joint friction and impact. In knee osteoarthritis, the cartilage wears away, and in severe cases of osteoarthritis knee, the bones may rub directly against each other with minimal lubrication, leading to pain and disability. Diagnosis of osteoarthritis of the knee is achieved usually with a typical medical history and confirmed by an X-ray of the knee joint. Some of the classical features you see on X-ray includes reduced joint space, irregularity of the bone, which we commonly call spikes or osteophytes, knee joint deformities. The risk factors of getting osteoarthritis of the knee includes previous knee injury like meniscal tear or ligamental tears or even fractures, excessive wear and tear of knee joints from high impact activities, increasing age. Osteoarthritis occurs more commonly in patients 50 years and older, but it can also occur sometimes in younger patients. Overweight. Patients who are overweight are almost twice as likely to develop osteoarthritis of the knee. Some of the common symptoms are gradual onset knee pain that develops over months to years, which is worse on walking and squatting or climbing of stairs, early morning stiffness, reduced range of motion, cracking sounds when you bend and extend the knees, and in acute flares, patients can even have severe pain and redness and swelling of the knee joint. What are the main modalities of treatment then, once diagnosis has been achieved? The first usually involves lifestyle changes. Reduce high impact activities like jumping and juggling to low impact activities like swimming and cycling. And as much as possible, try to maintain still an active lifestyle. Minimize activities that may aggravate the condition, like climbing of stairs or prolonged standing. Lose weight. Many patients ask me how they can lose weight if they are not supposed to do high impact activities. Well, like I've always said, 70% of weight loss comes from diet. Please click the link on the top right to assess the top 10 food to lose belly fat. Wear shoes with good sole support. I cannot emphasize this enough. Wearing of shoes that have poor support may add further stress to the knee joint, and invest in a good pair of shoes now. Secondly, exercise and physiotherapies. The knee joint is a very large joint that is stabilized by ligaments and muscles around it. Exercises that strengthen the muscles around the knee joint helps in managing the pain and helps in stabilizing the joint. At the end of this video, we will be showing you some exercises that you can do to help in managing your osteoarthritis. So watch till the end. 3. Medical treatment. There are medications to treat osteoarthritis. Glucosamine and chondroitin may help in some patients in reducing knee pain. However, it may not work for everyone. In general, I may start a patient on it for 3 to 4 months and will continue them on these supplements if it helps in reducing their knee pain. Pain medications. There is an array of pain medications that can help to reduce the discomfort, such as Panadol, NSAIDs, COX-2 inhibitors, opioids. These are medications that you take when required. I would advise patients not to be dependent on pain medications. Knee joint injections. In my practice, there are 2 types of knee joint injections that I do. The first would be the steroid injections. These injections help to reduce inflammation and helps in acute severe pain where patients may not be able to walk at all. However, there are side effects to steroid injections, and if done too frequently, may worsen the osteoarthritis in the long run. Please consult your doctor in detail about it. Secondly, would be hyaluronic acid viscose supplementation. These are injections of hyaluronic acid into the knee joints to replace the cartilage that has worn out. This gel-like materials will act as suspensions and provide lubrications at the same time. They are pretty effective, but they do not work for everyone. Finally, when all else fails or when there are severe deformities of the knee due to osteoarthritis, surgeons may recommend surgical knee joint replacements to replace the worn-out knee or to correct deformities. So, as promised, we will now zoom into the exercises that can help you manage your osteoarthritis of the knee. We have Alvin here, which will help us walk through some of the exercises that will benefit you in managing your osteoarthritis. Here we go.
Good day, everybody. Today, we're going to introduce some exercises to help with OA or osteoarthritis knee pain. Right, so for the first exercise, take a seat on a chair. Back straight, make sure that you don't lean on the back support, if possible. Right, keep your toes pointing forward, legs 90 degrees. Right, pick a choice of which leg to start off this exercise with and carry out the exercise like so. Straighten up your leg and go back down to the 90 degrees position again. And go up and down. Repeat this exercise for about 10 to 20 repetitions before carrying it out on the next leg. For the next exercise is something we call heel raises. Right, so stand behind the chair, hands on the backrest for support, toes pointing forward, look forward with your back straight, and tiptoe. Go up as high as you can before coming down, and up, and down, and up, and down. Make sure that you carry out this exercise as slow as possible. Don't rush through each repetition. The next exercise is what is known as side leg raises. Right, same thing as your heel raise. Rest your hands for support on the back rest of the chair. Toes pointing forward, back straight, and look forward. Right, pick a leg of your choice to carry out this exercise first. And go sideways. Lift your leg sideways, like so. Same thing. Try to execute this exercise as slow as possible. Keep your leg straight as you come up and the same way as you come down. The next exercise is called the single leg stand. Right, same way. Keep your hands on the backrest of the chair for support and raise one of your legs like so to a 90 degrees position. Right, keep it as this position for as long as you can for maybe about 30 to 60 seconds. And if with the support is too easy, right, what you can actually do is you can just lift your hands away and try to balance for the time remaining. Carry this exercise out for both legs. The last exercise is what we call the sit to stand exercise. Right, so start off this exercise seated, toes pointing forward 90 degrees. Right, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna try to stand up straight from a seated position, like so, and go back down again, and up, and down. When you're in the seated position, you can fully rest yourself with your back straight before going up, and down.
So thank you for watching till the end. I hope that the video was educational and provided you with some practical knowledge and tips to manage your knee pain. Share this video with your loved ones who are suffering from knee osteoarthritis. Subscribe, like, and share. There are many other videos in my channel which touches upon many other medical conditions. Feel free to access all of them. Until the next time, Stay safe, stay healthy.